5 सेकेंड, 2 सेकेंड, रेडी। व्हाट द रेस्पोंडेंट हैड डन बाई फाइलिंग द रिट पिटीशन वॉज टू हाईलाइट ग्रेव इरेगुलरिटीज कमिटेड बाई द वेस्टर्न रीजनल कमेटी ऑफ NCTE इन ग्रांटिंग रिकॉग्निशन टू प्राइवेट इंस्टीट्यूशंस हु डिड नॉट फुलफिल द मैंडेटरी कंडीशंस रिलेटिंग टू द फाइनेंशियल रिसोर्सेज एकोमोडेशन लाइब्रेरी लेबोरेटरी एंड अदर फिजिकल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर एंड क्वालिफाइड स्टाफ एंड एडमिटेड स्टूडेंट्स who had either not passed the entrance test or had not appeared for the centralized counseling conducted under the directions issued by the state government. The respondent derived support from the orders passed by the High Court in various cases. The statement made by Sri Rajiv Gandhi, Member Secretary NCTE, who appeared before this court on 21st July 2010, that effective steps have been taken after discovery of irregularities in the grant of recognition to various private colleges in the state of Madhya Pradesh and other states falling within the western region also gives a credence to the respondent's assertion that all was not well with the Western Regional Committee. In the pleadings filed before this court, the appellants have not suggested that the respondents had filed the writ petition to settle score with any institution or with some ulterior motive. Learned counsel for the appellants also did not make any such argument. Therefore, it cannot be said that the High Court committed error by entertaining the writ petition and ordering an inquiry into the allegations of irregularities committed in the matter of recognition and affiliation of self-financed private institutions and admission of the students by such institutions. If the High Court had not ordered re-scrutiny of the recognition affiliation granted to the private institutions, the irregularities committed by the Western Regional Committee may never have seen the light of the day, and we do not see any reason to nullify the exercise undertaken by the High Court to ensure that the provisions of the 1993 Act and regulations thereunder are strictly followed by the authorities entrusted with the task of granting recognition and affiliation to the institutions and colleges engaged in conducting teacher training courses. The next question which merits consideration is whether the impugned order is contrary to the rules of natural justice, that is ad alteram patern. In this context, it is apposite to note that in the impugned order, the High Court has not discussed eligibility or entitlement of any particular institution to get recognition or affiliation. What High Court has done is to interpret the relevant statutory provisions in the light of the judgments of this court and orders passed by it in other writ petitions. After examining the provisions of the 1993 Act and the regulations, the High Court held that subsection 3 of section 14 and clauses of regulation 7 and 8 of the regulations are mandatory, and that recognition can be granted to an institution intending to undertake teacher training course only if the mandatory conditions are fulfilled. The High Court also held that the examining body cannot grant affiliation to any institution unless इट इज़ रिकग्नाइज्ड बाय द NCTE।